visiting Medina, its virtues and significance. In Medina, also known as Taiba or Taba, the Prophet, peace be upon him, lived for 10 years, building the foundations of the Islamic nation. And referring to Medina, he, peace be upon him, said, indeed, it is Taiba. It removes sins as fire removes the dirt from silver. He, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, also said, Medina is better for them if they knew. Nobody leaves preferring another place to it, except that Allah replaces him with someone better than him. And nobody perseveres with his hard times and difficulties, except that I shall be for him on the day of resurrection, an intercessor or a witness. And the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, I have been ordered to go to a village that eats up other villages, which people call Yathrib, and it is Medina. It expels bad men as bellows remove dirt from iron. The Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, Medina is a sacred precinct, that which is between Ayr and Thawr, the two mountains. Whosoever does evil therein, or shelters an evil doer, then upon him is the curse of Allah, the angels and mankind altogether. The Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, Indeed, Ibrahim made Mecca a sacred precinct and prayed for it. And I have made Medina a sacred precinct, as Ibrahim did with Mecca. And I prayed for it in its mud and sa', that is, for its trade to increase. As Ibrahim, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, had done for Mecca. And the reward for the prayer in the Prophet's mosque is manifold. As the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, Salat in this mosque of mine is better than 1,000 of salat in any other place, apart from the Haram mosque. He, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, Between my house and my pulpit is a meadow from paradise, and my pulpit is on my hawd, or fountain. And he, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, The Dajjal will come to Medina and will find angels guarding it. No plague shall enter it, nor will Dajjal, insha'Allah. Also the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, prayed for it, saying, O Allah, put in Medina double of what you have put in Mecca in terms of blessings. Although visiting the mosque of the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is not part of the conditions of Hajj, and neither is it one of its pillars or obligations, it is a recommended act or sunnah, and can be performed at any time. Furthermore, it is compulsory that the intention for the visit should be to pray in the mosque, and not to visit the grave, as the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, No one should journey to any mosque except for three mosques, the Haram Mosque, the Prophet's Mosque, and Al-Aqsa Mosque. The ahadith about visiting the grave of the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, are all weak according to the consensus of the scholars of hadith. Rather, they are all fabricated, and none of the reliable narrators of the Sunan have related any of them, nor have any of the Imams used any of them as evidence. If the visitor reaches the mosque, it is sunnah for him to enter with his right foot, saying, Allahumma ftahli abwaab rahmatik, meaning, O Allah, open the doors of your mercy for me. Then he observes two raka'at to greet the mosque. It is better to observe the two raka'at in the area of the noble meadow. It is sunnah to visit the grave of the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, and those of his two companions, Abu Bakr and Umar. He, meaning the pilgrim, stands facing the grave of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and greets him politely in a low voice and asks Allah to bless him. Then he greets Abu Bakr and then Umar. It is sunnah for someone visiting the Prophet's mosque to pray the five daily prayers therein and engage in much remembrance of Allah and supplication to him there, and also perform many voluntary prayers, especially in the area of the noble meadow. It is also sunnah to visit the Quba Mosque to pray therein, and it is more preferable if such a visit takes place on a Saturday, according to the actions of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Furthermore, it is sunnah to visit the cemetery of Baqi' and the graves of Hamza, may Allah be pleased with him, and other martyrs, because the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, used to visit them to pray for them. And he would say, Assalamu alaykum, ahl al-diyari min al-mu'mineen wal-muslimin, wa inna insha'allahu bikum lafiqoon. أسأل الله لنا ولكم العافية. Which means, peace be upon you, O people of the graves, from among the believers and Muslims. Indeed, we shall join you if Allah wills. I ask Allah to grant us and you safety. It is not permitted to travel carrying luggage with the intention of visiting the Prophet's grave and other archaeological or historical sites in Medina. What is authorized is to travel to visit the Prophet's mosque to pray in it, while visiting the grave is included in the visit to the mosque. It is not allowed to face the grave when supplicating, just as it is not allowed to supplicate to the Prophet and seek one's needs from him, instead of Allah, the Most High. This is a form of major shirk. And it is also prohibited to rub the walls of the grave chamber in order to seek blessings. This is one of the forbidden innovations and is a means that leads to committing major shirk. Similarly, it is not permissible to raise one's voice while at the grave of the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. Stay there for a long time, repeat the Taslim from afar every time one enters the mosque, or place the right hand over the left on one's chest as done in Salah while saying the Salam greeting.